Hello, bookish friends. Welcome to the video in which I will talk about my 2024 reading goals. I'm always very excited to do those videos because in the last half of every year, I start thinking about next year's goals and decide on which goals I might do, then make little notes and adjust my ideas accordingly up until the time that I announce my reading goals. In this video, I will individually talk about each goal very briefly, and then in the second part of the video, I will talk about my primary goal for the year 2024, which I titled Goodreads TBR Challenge. For the Goodreads challenge, which I do every year, I chose 100 works in Goodreads to read. Ever since I started my channel, I always set my goal to 100 books, which is a target that is actually quite easy for me to reach. So this year, I will also repeat this challenge. Second challenge is actually my primary reading goal of 2024, Goodreads TBR challenge. I will talk more about this challenge in the second part of the video. But briefly, I can say that at the beginning of 2024, I will make sure that I will list 400 books on my Goodreads TBR list. At the end of 2024, I will try to decrease this number to at least 350 and less if I could make it. If you have been following me for a while, you know that I attend quite a number of real life and online book clubs. So I will participate in my two real life book clubs. One of them is a larger book club. Second one is actually an online book club with three of my best friends from university. As for my online book clubs, I will read books from Killer Reads book club hosted by AJ Dan Reads and Writes, Krista's patron book club, which is hosted by Books and Jams, Fear of Missing Out book club, hosted by Gemma, Alice and Jack, Christafest, hosted by Julie and Lil, and last but not least, I will be a part of Nancy Drew Read Along, hosted by Mitzi Reads and Writes. I will not read every book that is chosen for these clubs. Of course, I will read the books that are already on my TBR, as well as the books that I'm very, very interested in reading. I will not read books that only sounds interesting, which actually contributed to my rapidly growing Goodreads TBR. I plan to conclude the Books of Alfred Hitchcock project, which I have been doing for the previous 2 years. This challenge has been very interesting. I've read very, very good books, as well as really, really bad books and disappointing books. By the end of the year, I want to finish all of the books and make a wrap-up video about Books of Alfred Hitchcock project. In the order of movies release dates, the first book is The Trouble with Harry by Jack Trevor Story, which was written in 1949, and it was filmed as The Trouble with Harry in 1955. The second book is The Santerre des Morts, written in 1954 by Pierre Bloy and Thomas Narkiak. This book was filmed as Vertigo in 1958. The third book is Psycho by Robert Black, written in 1959, and it was adapted just a year later as Psycho in 1960. The next one is a short story, The Birds, written in 1952 by Daphne du Maurier, And this was filmed as The Birds in 1963. Fifth one is Marnie by Winston Graham, written in 1961. And this book was filmed with the same title, Marnie, in 1964. Next book is Topaz by Leon Uris, written in 1967. Again, filmed with the same title, Topaz, in 1969. The next book is Goodbye Pitagili, Farewell Leicester Square, written in 1966 by Arthur Le Bern. This book was filmed as Frenzy in 1972. And the last book adapted for the last movie of Alfred Hitchcock is The Rainbird Pattern by Victor Canning, written in 1972. And this book was filmed as The Family Plot. Some of the movies adapted among those books are the best works of Alfred Hitchcock. So I am very, very excited that I will hopefully finish this project in 2024. I always said that I love picking book names or prompts from cups. So this year I also have a cup to pick out book names from. I will name my cup TBR Wets Cup. I will put the names of the books that I stated that I would read in all of my TBR videos, and then put those books in TBR Wets Cup, and pick a book to read from those books. And of course, the books that I haven't read from the TBR videos are already on my Goodreads TBR. So by reading one a month, I will be able to decrease the number of books on my Goodreads TBR. This year, I will do a yearly reading challenge created by Chantel, which is Read Your Shelf Challenge. I will link the announcement video down below. This year, she created a very fun adventure type of challenge. I will choose to do the Arthur Conan Doyle path. As the title suggests, I will choose the books that were already on my Goodreads TBR before the year 2024 for this challenge. So it will fit my overall goal of 2024. This year, although I finished a quite number of series, I also decided to restart many series, so that the number of series that I'm currently in the middle of has increased quite a bit. I want to finish at least 10 series. I will try to focus on the series that I have less than 2 books left, which is currently 27 series, but by the end of the year, I think it will be 25. I will make a more detailed video about the series that I'm currently in the middle of. But I can say that this goal is also adjusted so that it would fit my Goodreads TBR challenge. The last yearly challenge that I plan to do is Reading Around the World challenge. It's a challenge that I will continue doing. Started this challenge this year in 2023, which was quite a success. I will talk more about which countries that I've read in my reading goals wrap-up videos. I want to read books taking place in at least 25 different countries, and additionally I want to read books set in 10 new different countries than the countries in my 2003 list. Doing this challenge last year was quite enjoyable for me. I'm thinking it will be the same this year. Like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, my primary goal for 2024 is to decrease the number of books on my Goodreads TBR list. The number of books on my Goodreads TBR has doubled over the last 2 years. Although I own significantly less number of physical books that I haven't read than many of my friends, this number on the list of books that I intend to read has started to overwhelm me, especially in the last 3 months of this year. I see some books that I've added like 5 years ago and still haven't read. The new books, especially the ones that I've added because it was very easy to find them on my Storytel application, became more and more interesting, and I read more and more from those books on my Storytel application, which is actually not a bad thing, but I also want to read the books that are already on my Goodreads TBR. So I actually adjusted many of the reading challenges that I saw on BookTube to my reading life, which is very much dominant on the digital side with ebooks and audiobooks. I have currently about 390 books on my Goodreads TBR. I will make sure that it is 400 at the beginning of 2024, just because I like nice and round numbers. And speaking of round numbers, I want to decrease the number of books on my TBR to at least 350 by the end of 2024. How I construct my Goodreads TBR is also very specific to me. I only have one book per one author, with the exception of Agatha Christie and Mary Higgins Clark, because I'm currently in the middle of two series from both of those authors. And I also put just one book from one series. So when I finish a book from a series, unless that series is finished, I automatically add the next book on the series to my Goodreads TBR. Unless I finish a series, the number of books on my Goodreads TBR do not change when I read books from series. I will have monthly check-in videos about this Goodreads TBR challenge. In those videos, I will talk about the books that I've added to my Goodreads TBR, which would be BookTube recommendations. But unlike previous years, I will not put the books that only sounds interesting. I will put the books I'm almost certain that I will read. So I will try not to put so many books from BookTuber recommendations this year. Like I mentioned before, I will also put the next books in the series, unless I finish those series. I will of course put physical and digital books that I hold, gifted or borrowed. And of course, I will put the books that are featured in next month's TBRs, if they are not already on my Goodreads TBR list. In that videos, I will of course mention the books that are taken out from TBRs. I will mention the books that I've read that month. I will mention the books that I DNF'd. And I will mention the books that I've unhauled. I will try to make a try a chapter video with the books that I'm not sure that I still want to keep on my TBR. Lastly, I will give the total number of books on my Goodreads TBR at the end of the previous month in that video. I will conduct my check-in videos like Alice does in her channel, Alice and the Giant TBR, which is always fun to see at the end of each month's wrap-up videos. Lastly, I will talk about the strategies that I found in order to achieve this overall goal. I'm a member of NetGalley and Book Sirens, and I really do like finding about new authors from those sites. But I will limit myself to only one book requested per month for those sites in 2024. I really do like using my public library for the books written in Turkish language. But before I go to the library, I will have a list of Turkish books on my TBR. Books translated to Turkish from the languages other than English. Lastly, although it's not directly related to Goodreads TBR challenge, I will try to choose books that I could use for my Turkish Shelf video series. For my online book clubs, I will join them if the books are already on my TBR or They are the books that I really, really want to read, not just the ones that sounded interesting or not just the ones that I want to try. Lastly, you know how much I love joining readathons, reading challenges, the social activities in BookTube. We'll try to have a mental checklist in choosing books for these social events in BookTube. Other than the books already selected for BuddyReads Book Club, TBR Red Cup or Alfred Hitchcock books, I will first of all check my physical books TBR. I will first try to choose books from the physical books on my Goodreads TBR, and then the Storytel books in my Goodreads TBR, and then the other books on my Goodreads TBR. I will choose the books not on my Goodreads TBR as the last option. I think if I follow these steps, I can find many books from the 400 books that already exist on my TBR to read in those social events. So this was my video of 2024 reading goals, with a special focus on my primary reading goal of Goodreads TBR challenge. I will do two more videos. One will focus on the series that I'm currently in the middle of, and in the other video we will create the TBR Reds Cup together. So please comment down below. Do you also have quite a number of books on your Goodreads TBR? Are you feeling overwhelmed like I do? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! For Turkish word of the day, since one of the challenges include TBR veterans, I thought veteran should be the word of the day. Veteran means kıdemli in Turkish, and kıdemli is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!